Hey, hi, welcome guys. Welcome back to our channel, which is Pybron. Today I'm going to discuss about chi-square testing. What is the chi-square testing? So in the earlier session, we had discussed about the different kind of another testing, which we used to perform the hypothesis testing, like a JET testing and student t-testing, right? So today we are going to discuss about the chi-square testing. Basically, many of you will get confused which kind of testing we have to perform at which moment, right? So don't worry about all those things. We will give the conclusion of all those pointers. I found some of the questions over our comment section. Ki, sir, what kind of testing we have to perform at which moment? They are not going to understand. Because concept-wise, they understood my JET testing, what is the JET testing, what is the T testing, and what is the chi-square testing also you will get to know in a while, right? So no doubt at all, no worries. We will give complete answer at the end of this session, right? So first we will understand the chi-square testing. Basically, chi-square testing is going to use, again, any new thing you are going to learn. So first thing, we are going with some story, right? So basically, I'm going to give one story here. I have a family of six member. I have a family of six member in the year of 2020. Right now, it's a 2020. And after the 10 years, what is going to be happen, this complete six means this main family, you can say this is the main family. And this main family is going to distribute it into the three subfamily, family number one, family number two, family number three. Let's suppose try to understand each family having their three members. And let's suppose family one, member number one is going to be suffer with the TB. Okay, so this is the one kind of disease, I don't know, this is the, you know, kind of genetic disease, you can say. Okay, so this one family member, one member of this family F1 is going to suffer with TB. He went to consult with the doctor, and doctor is going to say, have anywhere in your family member is suffered with this disease or not in the earlier. So what this family member will do, he will go to each family member, family means F1, F2, F3, and main family also. And he will try to understand whether anyone was suffering with this kind of disease in the earlier, right? So what before going to be done this task, what we have to do? First thing, we have to check whether F2 is belong to this main family or not. Let's suppose this F1 went to the another family member and he is trying to identify these things. So in order to overcome this kind of problem, first we have to ensure this F2 is the family of this main family or not, right? First thing, we have to ensure these things. Then only we can apply all those questions on this family member, right? So without blindly, we cannot ask this kind of question with any family member. First thing, you have to identify whether this F2 or F3 belong to our main family or not, right? So in order to do this kind of analysis, in order to do this kind of testing, we are going to use, chi-square testing, sorry. So chi-square testing is used to test the goodness of fit, basically. This is the term you can use, goodness of fit. So basically, whenever you want to do this kind of testing, you can perform the goodness. And now how we are going to incorporate these things in the real time, that we will see in a while. Don't worry at all, right? But the things I'm going to incorporate all those things with the story, so that you will also make your interest here. One thing. Another thing you can say, let's suppose I'd like to give you one real time problem here, which we are supposed to solve with the chi-square testing. Every analytics should do this, right? One thing is what, let me explain you. One thing is what, let's suppose your product manager or your stakeholder given one problem statement one. And he given one data set also. Mr. X, this is the problem statement, this is the data set, and now you have to apply all those ML algorithm, all those things, EDA, everything, data cleaning, data pre-processing, everything you have to do on the top of this data set. And at the end of these things, what you are going to do, you applied all those things, you did, and you made your, you solved your problem statement, and you went to product manager, and product manager is going to reply, Hey users fellow, this data set is not belong to that data set or that problem statement. Now what the response you are going to get? You cannot say anything to your product manager, right? You are a statistician, you are a data scientist, your responsibility, your job it is to ensure whether this data set is belong to that particular problem statement or not, right? So in order to do these things, we are going to implement chi-square testing. Got it? So basically, chi-square testing, how it works, chi-square testing, summation of observed value minus expected value divided by expected value. So this, in this way, I'll show you with the one example, with the one problem statement, we will clear this doubt, right? So hope up to this, you got the clear picture about the chi-square testing, right? Now, again, everything will be same in case of chi-square testing. How we were doing the Z-score testing, Z-testing, we were using Z-table, right? And here also we will use chi table. Okay, so let's go with the, without going to be delay here, I'll show you something. This is the formula I just showed you, right? And now this is the problem statement, right? So problem statement is what? A university conducted a survey on its recent graduate to collect demographic and health information for the future planning purpose, as well as access students' satisfaction with their undergraduate exercise, right? The survey revealed that the substantial proportion of students were not engaging in regular exercise. Many felt their nutrition was poor, and a substantial number were smoking. In response to question on regular exercise, 60% of all graduates reported getting no regular exercise. 25% reported exercise substantially, and 15% reported exercising regularly as undergraduate. The next year, university launched a health promotion campaign on campus in an attempt to increase health behavior among the undergraduate. The program include modules on exercise, nutrition, and smoking cases. Okay. And to evaluate the impact of the program, the university again surveyed the graduate and asked the same question. And the survey was completed by 470 graduates, and the following data were collected, right? So now what is the data right now? We having no regular exercise data. How many, out of 470, how many graduate student are not doing regular exercise? That is 255. Subordinate is 125. Regular exercise is 90. And total number, if you add all those things, you will get 470. Now we have to check whether this data is belong to that particular observation or not. It is satisfying that observation or not, right? So that are the things we are going to do. Okay. So hope you understood this. So you can see, if you can see these things. Okay, so what we are going to do, so p-value, we are going to, nothing but p-value is what? Probability of accepting the null hypothesis or rejecting the null hypothesis. So 60%, as we know, 60% of total graduate is not doing regular exercise. This is 60% and 0.6. 25% is doing subordinate, and 15% only were doing regular exercise. So this is the P1, P2, P3. That's all. It's a null hypothesis. Or eventually you can say distribution response is 0.6, 0.25, 0.15, right? Now, as a statistician, this is our observed value. This is our observed value. In the first row, whatever data we have, this is our observed value. Okay. Now, what is the expected value we have right now? So 470 into 0.6, 282. 470 into 0.25, because this is the subordinate, right? The subordinate we have to multiply with this, and we will get this will be our expected value. Now again, regular exercise wala, we will get 70.5. if you are going to apply our chi-square formula, what is the chi-square formula here? Expected minus observed divided by, or observed minus expected, whatever you can take, because it's a whole square, so everything will be work fine. Okay, so now, so if you are going to apply this formula on the top of this, what we were getting 8.46. you can calculate, you can apply your calculator or scientific calculator. You can calculate this as I already calculated for you. You can check this thing, right? So we will get our chi-square value. Now, and here also one thing is given, alpha value also. What is the alpha value? Level of significance. What is the level of significance? Level of significance is nothing but, critical area. If our observation will fall under this critical area, then we have to reject our null hypothesis. And if it will not fall under that critical area, then we have to accept our null hypothesis. What is the null hypothesis here? The distribution of this data set is correct. This is our null hypothesis. Now, we got our chi-square value, right? And we got our alpha value. Now, let me show you how to check the chi-square table, okay? So just go to the Google, just go to the Google chi-square table here. So CHI chi-square table in PDF, and you will get many of the link. Don't worry, you can select any of the link. So any of the link you can select, okay. So basically, yeah, this will work fine for me. Okay. So here, in order to check the chi-square table, you should know two things. One is degree of freedom and another is level of significance, right? So level of significance, though, we had, right? We having the level of significance. Now, degree of freedom. What is the degree of freedom? Basically? So degree of freedom is nothing but here, if you can see this in my slides, if you can see, how many category we have? No regular exercise, subordinate exercise, regular exercise. Three category. So degree of freedom always, sample size, or you can say, or category minus one. So here three category, the degree of freedom will be 3 - 1, 2. So you can see here, I'll annotate this 1 minute. If you can see, my degree of freedom is fall here and my level of significance is 0.5. If I'm going to intersect this point, what I'm getting? 5.99. I'm getting chi-square value at 0.05 is 5.99. Okay. Now coming to that slide. Okay. So 5.99. You got right. How you will get the chi-square value with the level of significance? You have to come this chi-square table and you can find it out. Now the main thing is what? Main thing is that whether we have to accept or reject, right? This is our main job, right? So for that, just come in here and here our chi observed means calculated chi value is what? Calculated chi value is 8.46 and our that table is saying 5.99, right? 5.99. Now let me share my screen 1 minute. So if you can see this, so 1 minute, this is our normally distributed curve, right? We had seen so far. Now, this is our normally distributed graph. And now our, the chi-square value, which came from table, which is 5.99, which belongs something here, 5.99, right? And now our, calculated value. Where is our calculated value? 8.46, right? 8.46, this is our critical area, right? And where 8.46 will lie after the 5.99? So 8.46 will lie here. So should I reject the null hypothesis or accept the null hypothesis? What you are saying with this? See, if this calculated value will fall under this region, then we can happily accept our null hypothesis. But unfortunately, this calculated value is fall under the critical area. This is our critical area, okay? So we have to reject the null hypothesis. Means whatever data point we got, that is not belong to the earlier data point. This we got the conclusion with this calculation, right? So hope you understood this situation. Hope you understood the chi-square things, right? And if you feel something I missed, then please post your query over the comment section. Happily, we can answer your question. Thanks for watching this. Thanks. That's all for today's session. And hope you enjoyed. If you like this video, then please do like, share, subscribe our channel. Thank you for that.